Hi, I'm Kate. In this video, we'll cover the steps you should take if the meta description you had set up with Rank Math doesn't appear in search results. Two studies conducted in 2020 have shown that Google disregards around two-thirds of the meta descriptions that were set up by content creators. We've added links to both of them in this video's description. Instead of showing the meta description, it might truncate, which means to cut off before the end of the text. It could also select other text from the page, or even gather keywords. It will depend on the term that was searched, in an effort to make the snippet more relevant. So let's start by checking if you have set a meta title and description with Rank Math. You can view this in the meta tags that appear at the beginning of the page's source code. You could also use the website that we've linked to in the description of this video. To edit the meta description, open Rank Math's meta box in the post editor. If you're using Classic Editor, scroll down the page and you'll find the meta box under the content. If you use Gutenberg, click on the button with Rank Math's icon and the SEO score on the top right corner of the screen. On the first tab of the meta box, click on Edit Snippet. You can use the buttons on the top right corner of the pop-up to preview the results on mobile and desktop. Next, make sure that the schema settings are valid. Still in Rank Math's meta box, go to the Schema tab and click on the paper and pencil icon to open the Schema Builder. The headline field must show the variable SEO title, while description should have SEO description. This will ensure that the SEO title and description set up with Rank Math are also used for this page's structured data. Once you've confirmed that the meta description you have set is actually what is shown in your page's source, you can proceed to check whether Google has picked up on the changes. To find out when Google's cache was last updated for the page, you'll need to see it in the search results. Enter the page or post's URL into Google's search bar. Click on the small downwards pointing arrow next to the domain. Then click on Cached to open the version of that page that was last crawled and indexed. On the top, there will be the date and time when it was crawled. If the cache date is from before adding the new meta description, you can wait for Google to recrawl or re-index the page. Or you can try our Instant Indexing free plugin. Click on the card to learn all about it. Now you might be wondering, is making a meta description even worth my time? We believe it is. Even though one of the studies we mentioned earlier shows that a quarter of the pages that occupy the first 10 positions don't have a meta description, it can serve several purposes. Before anything else, it's an opportunity to attract the audience. Also, the meta description is used in social shares, unless you add specific descriptions via Rank Math. But most importantly, it can be an opportunity to work with long-tail keywords. Those are longer phrases that are much more specific, which usually makes them easier to rank for because the competition is smaller. If you decide to carry on making meta descriptions, let's talk about how to increase the chances of Google showing them. Like we mentioned earlier in this video, the snippet will depend on the term that was searched, so that it's more relevant. So if the description doesn't match what the user is searching for, but other content on the page does, it will be used instead. Also, if the exact same meta description is provided across a large number of pages, it will be disregarded. And even though sometimes Google itself uses a collection of keywords that it finds on the page, if you try to write a description with several keywords that are not relevant to the content, it won't be used either. This information was given by Google's John Mueller during an online session of Google Webmaster Central Office Hours. His suggestion was to make sure that your pages have unique meta descriptions that are short enough to fit into a snippet on a page, and that they match what users would generally be looking for when they're going to that page. If you want to watch the whole session, click on the card. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find more tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/KB.